Hey guys, what's up? In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to fold this amazing transforming fidget toy called Clic Clac. It's a stellated octahedron that collapses into a square, and then you press the sides and it becomes a 1x1x2 box, and then you press the other sides and it goes back and forth like this. And then it flattens, and when you press these, it goes back into the stellated octahedron. This model was designed by Paolo Bascetta, who gave me his permission to teach it, and it spins. All right, and now I will show you how to fold it. Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this model, I'm going to use, well, two squares, but actually it's 4 1x2 rectangles, and we're gonna make a bunch of pre-creases. So I think it's just easier to make all of the pre-creases on the two squares and then divide them into the 2x1 rectangles. So here goes. Begin colored side up and fold in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply and repeat. Fold to the crease and unfold and repeat on the other three sides. And fold the edge to the last crease. Unfold and repeat. And fold to the first crease. And repeat. Okay, turn over and fold diagonally in half. Unfold and repeat. Blints. Fold to the intersection. Unfold and repeat on the other three corners. And fold to this intersection point. And repeat. Okay, fold in half again and fold sharply, unfold, turn over, and now we're going to tear all the way down. So make a little tear right there, and now with this crease sticking up as a ridge, tear all the way down. Like that. And we have 2 2x1 rectangles with the full crease pattern. Repeat this on this sheet of paper. And I'm going to fast forward this part. All right, now fold the bottom edge up and the top edge down. And now turn over top to bottom and fold this edge to the middle, letting the flap swing out like that, and repeat on top. and rotate and fold up like this and fold this edge down. And now fold these flaps like this. Okay. Now, holding here like this, take this flap, slide it out, and lift it up. And now holding here, take this flap, slide it out, and lift it up. And repeat. So hold like this, slide out, bring down, and hold here, slide out, and bring down. And the first one is done. Repeat that on the other three. And I'm going to fast forward this part. All right, so all four units are complete. Now it's time to assemble them. So right now they're oriented with the slits on the top and bottom, so they look like a really plump letter H. And now switch these two and rotate these two like this. All right, now we're going to insert this flap into there like that. And then to make it stay, take this flap and fold it behind. So it's like this. I'm going to show you what it looks like from the other side. It's like that. Okay, now get your next unit. And this one, it goes in like this. And once again, to lock it, you take this flap and you fold it behind. And the last one, insert it like this. And lock it. And now take these two flaps and switch their place. So this one goes on top like that and insert it underneath there. Push it together and lock it. Okay, so these are locked. And now turn it over and crease sharply. Now fold this up like this and rotate and fold this one up and insert this flap underneath like this. And rotate and repeat. So fold this flap like this and insert the flap into the pocket. And one more time, fold like this and insert this flap into there like that. And now we're going to switch these flaps. So that means that this one goes on top and this one goes on the bottom. And now take this flap and insert it in like that. And crease it nice and sharply. Okay, now turn over, and here comes the most difficult step. We have to take these flaps and tuck them inside the pockets. So what you can do is squeeze like that, pinch it, and now just push it in, and that corner needs to go past this point. So you need to push it in, and then it just goes right to the middle like a blintz. like that. And repeat. So first open the pocket a little bit, pinch, and then go in and fold it. So inside there, it's just like the corners going to the middle, like a blintz fold. Like we're folding a blintz fold on the bottom layers. It's important that they stay together as we do that. That's why we're pinching them. Okay, and one more. And now, this is what it looks like. Now just push these flaps in. Reverse fold. Make sure that you're on the creases. And crease it sharply. All right, so here's the finished model, and this is how it works. So you just press on the sides, and it becomes a 2x1 box. And now go back to here and press on these sides, and it becomes a 2x1 box in this direction. And now you can just press here between these two points and between these two points like that. And it becomes a box in this direction. And now you press these two points and these two points and it flips to that box. And then press these two points and these two points like that. So we're starting out like this. And once it exercises really well and gets used to doing this, then you can just press right here and it should flip like that. So you can just press only two corners and it switches. Yeah. And then the other cool thing, so go back to the flat square. When you press these opposite corners, then it goes into a stellated octahedron. But first we need to push these corners in order to make it look good. Like that. So going back, it's like this, you press, and there it is. Or press here. Yeah, these might come out a little bit, but hopefully you can train them to stay in. And then once again, it goes to the 1x1x2 box. All right, hope you guys like that, find this interesting. I think it's a really cool, fun model, and it's even really hard to take it apart if you don't know how. So have fun playing with this model and showing it to your friends, and I'll see you guys later.